Welcome to YouTuber Headlines. My name's Oakley, your go-to source for YouTube mom drama news and updates. Typically, I post videos 3 times a week, but this year I decided to participate in Vlogmas. But I'm no vlogger. I definitely don't vlog. Welcome to Dramas. I'll be posting new videos Monday through Friday until Christmas. I did not come up with that name Dramas. A viewer did. I asked you guys over on Instagram for suggestions, and I said if I choose your suggestion, I will send you a PayPal treat. So a viewer came up with Dramas. I loved it, and I sent her a PayPal treat for helping me come up with that name. If you're not following me on Instagram, go check me out at YouTuber Headlines. I post daily over there. Today, I want to talk about YouTube mom Brianna K, also known as Bits of Bri. I would say I get messages about Bri almost daily, especially when she puts out a new video. And she put out a new video yesterday, so we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about one of her high school classmates and what she had to say about Bri. We're going to talk about, I don't know, there's so much I have in my little Bri folder here. I'm pulling it all out today.
Now, click that thumbs up if you love cleaning motivation, and be sure to hit the subscribe button, because if you click it right there, then I get an extra special treat for myself today. So please,
you know, nice. Thanks. All right. I've never seen her ask for subscribers like that before, but a lot of people are saying that she has been buying subscribers, because now she's at 419,000 subscribers and she just hit 400,000 this year. So I don't know. This is a shot from Bri's most recent video. The shots, the angles, the poses that she does in her videos are very interesting to me. And I've talked about this many times before. I'll link a few videos in the description box. But I don't know what to say. Let's read what Bri had to say, because she was really trying to sell those shorts in this video. I put the link to my biker shorts in the description box because they are the best. So comfy. And I got DMs from other people who got them too, and they said they're ordering more. The shorts are great. I like the shorts. They seem comfortable. It's not about her clothing. I think angles are super important. YouTubers think about their angles. They think about how they're going to look in the frame. All of this is planned out, and this was her planned shot. Plus, she edited this video. I got this message from a viewer. Bri uploaded a new video today. I saw this comment with her reply about when she finds the time to clean. Technically saying, no, Adam doesn't help with the kids. This is so strange. Does he not do anything? I mean, he doesn't have a job. Are they even together? A viewer asked Bri, does Adam watch the kids while you deep clean? I feel like I can't deep clean because my little ones are attached to my hip. Bri said, my older two are pretty independent now. I can have them play or do an activity if I need to get something done. But I try to do most of my cleaning during Hayden's 2 nap times when they're at school. In her most recent, I think it was morning routine video, the entire morning she showed herself doing everything. Adam didn't do anything in the video. He was there because he said something to the dog, but she pretty much filmed herself doing everything. And I know some viewers are going to say, well, this is just like 10 minutes of her life. You don't really get to see what really happens. Well, YouTubers put up these morning routines and portray this is their real life, and they portray this image that this is what happens in their morning. So why wouldn't we think that this is what happens in their morning? This is her morning routine and her husband doesn't help. I think if he doesn't want to be on camera, she could say, really, guys, this is a fake ass video I'm making here. My husband doesn't want to be on camera, but actually he does help me. But I'm going to give you a fake video today of what it would be like if my husband didn't help me. I mean, I don't get it. I don't get why you would put out these fake videos, because if your husband is there, what is he doing? Why is he not helping? Why don't you just say what's going on? Why does she make it sound like she does everything? She makes it sound like she does all the cleaning, she takes care of the kids, she does the school runs, she's the sole provider of the family, she pays all the bills. People are like, what does your husband do? Like I said, it's fine if Adam doesn't want to be on camera, but I think there should be a little disclaimer there. Hey, my husband doesn't feel comfortable on camera, so this is my morning routine when he doesn't help me at all. Do you guys remember last week when she said something on Instagram about not being the best mom because she didn't do artistic after school snacks? A viewer said, when your snacks look so sad but you need a picture for the gram, just fill in the rest with Photoshop. Yeah, I'm not making that up. She literally Photoshopped her snack so it would look cute on Instagram. It's not her snack. It was a snack for her kids. I got this message from a viewer. She said, hi there, I wanted to let you know that Bits of Brie blocked me on Instagram. I have never commented on any of her posts, stories, nor have I ever liked anything of hers. I'm not even sure how she knows I even exist. Maybe you can make a video about her behavior and blocking people for no reason. I've seen comments on your videos from others claiming she did the same to them. Like I said, I don't even know why she did or how she even knows I exist. Do you think she has someone going through her followers and checking who they follow? She sounds a little paranoid. I get messages every week from viewers saying they were blocked by Brie for no reason. So I definitely think she is spending all of her time doing this, searching for viewers, blocking them for no reason, or she's paying her assistant to do this, which that's probably what's happening. Just blocking people for no reason. People who have never engaged with you at all on Instagram, you're blocking them. Very petty. Another viewer reached out to me and said that she watches a lot of Brie's videos and she often chats with Brie during her premieres. She has the same profile picture on YouTube that she does on Instagram. Brie talks to her on YouTube all the time, likes her comments, but blocked her on Instagram. A viewer asked Brie, were you prom queen? And she said, no, but this is my senior picture. Next, we're going to talk about the messages I received from a girl that went to high school with Brie. Now, before I read you guys these comments, I want to say a few things. I realize that when you're in high school, you're a different person than you are when you're in your 30s. I believe Brie is in her 30s I think she's in her early 30s. I don't keep up with everybody's ages, so I might be wrong on that. But I understand that who you are in high school may not be who you are as an adult. I get that. And I also understand that I'm giving this person's perspective of what she saw in high school, what she experienced, and how she felt. We don't have Brie's side. Also, this person gives some pretty intimate details, but there's no way for me to confirm, verify, or prove that this is a person that actually went to school with Brie. But she does give some very, very interesting details. So you guys, feel free to form your own opinion about this. I am giving you information. I am not trying to tell you how to think. I went to high school with Brianna. When I heard she was on YouTube, I watched a few videos and I was shocked by this image she portrays of her childhood. It's all fabricated. She was a rich kid. She had money. She didn't struggle. And I was shocked to hear her say that she had body image issues. She was a cheerleader and always showing off her body. Her and Dina, who is ABC Learning on Instagram, were best friends in high school, and I was close to Dina. We played sports together, but Brianna K and the rest of her group she's still friends with, Bridget and Steph K on Instagram, they were awful to me, and they called themselves the Plastics and treated me and my friends terribly. She was a grade below me and would show up to parties I was at or school dances, and her friends would call us names and make us miserable. They'd sit in the corner and take selfies of themselves before selfies were even a thing. I specifically remember one party Brianna told me to move my ugly blank because the lighting where I was sitting was better and she wanted to sit there with her friends and take selfies. It was wild. Her and Dina drove matching silver Eclipse convertibles. She competed in all pageants in town and strutted her stuff like she was the best thing since sliced bread. She was not nice. Dina was so nice, I could never figure out why Dina hung around with her. I did ask this person over and over again, are you sure it's okay to share this information? Because these are pretty specific details and Bits of Brie might know who this is and she might message her or something. And she said it was perfectly fine to share this. She wanted to share this, so we're sharing it. I also understand that there are three sides to every story. Her side, Brie's side, and the truth. We all have our own perception of a situation, but this is her side. This is what she felt in high school. This is what she saw. This is what she went through. And this might be completely different from what Brie might say. Look, YouTubers are micro celebrities. That's my opinion. They just are. And viewers want to know more about them. And as much as YouTubers complain about people talking about them, do you think they like some of the attention they get? I mean, they have to. How do you put yourself on YouTube? You put yourself in front of the camera, you talk about yourself, you show your life, you brag about all your stuff, your vacations, your homes. You like attention. I shared what Bree's high school classmate had to say about her. But I will say there are certain things that I don't share on my channel. And some people have reached out to me about other YouTube moms with very personal stuff. My point is, I don't just share anything and everything. A viewer sent me this screenshot. This is a Febreze ad, and Bree was featured on the Febreze Instagram account. Something like this paid thousands of dollars. She's done so many sponsorships in December, and it's only December the 7th. YouTubers and influencers really focus on sponsorships during this time because brands pay more in November and December than they pay all year. I just realized I didn't include any of the information from the viewer who took Bree's course, so I will include that in an upcoming video. That's it for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow.